So she started playing with me with the dildo. So she sticks the dildo in me and she starts, you know, fucking me with the dildo.
Black girl magic got your attention. Make her body like them Donald. Tell me this pussy better turn around and fumble. Talk that shit, must have thought I was a Rhonda. Megan told y'all it's a hot girl summer. Pretty ass lady, but I'm so nasty.
What's up, you guys? It's your girl, Renita Lane, and we're back up in this thing, y'all. And we back with another video. And as y'all read by the title, you already know we back with a lit ass story time. Okay, so grab your popcorn, grab your drinkity drink, or whatever it is that you need to grab to get yourself ready for this story time. Baby, go grab that shit, cause yeah, it's about to go down. So let's get into this motherfucking story time. Okay, y'all, so a lot of y'all always ask me, have I ever been with a girl by myself? And y'all always asking me to do a story time of me being with a girl by myself. I get them DMs on my Instagram all the time. Y'all wanna know story times like that. It's like, damn, y'all don't wanna see me with no dude and a girl. Y'all don't wanna see me do no more threesome story times. Y'all just wanna see me with a, you know, with a female by myself. I know y'all love my threesome story times, but yeah, I thought, why not go ahead and give y'all this cringy ass story time? Because y'all, this story time is cringe. I mean, it's cringe to me. You know, it's cool. It was what it was. You know, we tried. We tried. So the girl that I'm talking about, we're gonna call her, what we gonna call her? I don't know what I'm calling, cause I'm not gonna say her real name. I'm just gonna call her, I'm gonna call her Judy. We just gonna call her Judy, okay? So Judy and I, we met through social media, through Instagram, okay, on social media. This is how I met her, okay? Originally, I was supposed to do this video with this guy on Instagram. You know, he's an influencer on Instagram. He does all these funny skits. I'll probably put his Instagram right here so y'all can go check out his skits because he is really, really funny. Okay, so he does skits and stuff like that. He had hit me up in my DM asking me to do this particular skit with someone that was coming into town. Now, the person that he asked me to do the skit with, he is known for giving women these sexual massages that be looking like these women really finna get a happy ending, if you know what I mean. Yeah, so he was about to link up with that dude. I can't remember his name, but I'm sure a lot of you ladies may know who I'm talking about. But he was in Dallas at the time. He told me, hey, you should link up. This would be a good opportunity, you know, good exposure, yada, yada, yada. So I was like, oh, damn. At the time, I think I was busy with work. I had a lot of stuff going on. I knew I wasn't going to make it in enough time that he wanted me to make it in to be able to do the video. So I couldn't do the video anymore. So this is where Judy comes into play. So I couldn't do the video anymore, and I was originally supposed to do the video because he came to me and asked me, but I wasn't able to do the video. So Judy ended up being in the video. So he ended up using Judy, and that's how I even discovered her Instagram page and things like that. So she ended up doing the skit, doing the video with the two gentlemen that were trying to get to do the video with them, okay? So yeah. So she did the video and I watched it and I laughed. I was like, damn, you know, it was a good video. You know, I was like, damn, I was supposed to be in that video, but it's cool. You know what I'm saying? She did her thing, whatever. So then I ended up following her page. So I just followed her, never really said much to her. You know, I might've liked a picture or two or three or four, you know, whatever. When I met her, it was back maybe, well, whenever I found out about her, it was like maybe 2018. I want to say it was 2018, but I can't really remember for sure. But it was like around that time. O's birthday was coming up or something like that. I believe it was his birthday coming up, or we was just going out. We was about to do something. No, it was her birthday. Let me take that back. It was her birthday. She had a birthday coming up and she didn't really know what she was going to do for her birthday at the time. So I was just like, hey, you know, we could take you out. Referring to me and O, right? And of course, you know, when I'm trying to get a girl to come out, and it seemed like, you know, she would be down with it. You know, I figured maybe she down. She seemed like she'd be down with it. I done seen her post little things here and there about threesomes and shit like that. So I was just like, you know, why not try to give it a go? You know what I'm saying? Why not? You know, throw yourself out there. You never know. So I end up, you know, telling her like, you know, we can go out. We can do something. We'll take you out. And I don't know if she really knew like what, you know, might have go down or whatever, but if you put two and two together, I'm trying to take you out with my nigga. come on. Yeah, so, and she was like, you know, yeah, cool, we can go out. So we had already set the day, had already planned, like, you know, we was gonna go out. We didn't know really exactly what we were gonna do. We just knew we was gonna go out, take her out, turn up and stuff like that. The time rolled around and, you know, she flaked. She flaked, you know what I'm saying? She said something came up.
I have to say, you are one very convincing liar.
Even to her, she said something came up, but to me, I was like, bitch, you stood me up. Like, bitch, you backed out. You backed out. But leave it up to her. She gonna tell y'all, like, no, I did not stand you up. Something really did come up. And she does have a son, so she did say something happened, you know, where she couldn't find a babysitter. So, you know, that's understandable, but you know me. I'm like, bitch, you stood me up. You stood me up. But no, so that happened and we never did anything. Fast forward maybe like some months or so later, maybe a year later, maybe months later, I don't really know. But fast forward, fast forward to last year. So last year, it had been a minute since I talked to her since that time. A year or so had passed. And last year, she had made like a video or something like that. Or maybe it wasn't last year, maybe it was like 2019. She had made a video. And if I can find the messages, I will post what I was commenting back to what she had said. But she had made some video referencing about eating pussy and like, you know, I'll eat pussy, you know, I'm down to eat pussy. It was something that she said with pussy and her eating pussy. So, you know me, I'm like, I gave her the eyes and I'm like, the eye emoji's like, really, you know? And she was like, yep, sure will. And I said, bet, I'ma keep that as a mental note. And she said, bet, okay? And that was it, and that was all I said, you know? So now, going to next year, okay? Fast forward to last year in 2020, that's when we really kind of reconnected or whatever. I don't really know how. If I can find the messages on like what we said or whatever, I'll probably post it or whatever. But I think we said something. She was like, hey, let's try it again or something like that. And I was like, man, you stood me up. Because remember, I said, I always tell her she stood me up, and she always tell me like she never stood me up, like something came up or whatever. So we always had that little tit-tit thing going on. So we laughed about it, whatever. And we just had a conversation. We just got to talking. So after that, we was kind of like texting each other and stuff like that. You know, just talking, you know, kind of getting to know each other, whatever. Okay, y'all. So y'all know at the time, I worked at a hookah lounge, at a nightclub hookah lounge at the time. So I was getting ready to go to the nightclub at the hookah lounge. Like I said, we had been talking. And she was just like, hey, you know, you want to come through? And I was like, well, I got to go to work. I'm going to be at work. She was like, well, you can pull up afterward. I was like, girl, I get off of work at like 4 a.m. in the morning. You is not going to be up, bitch. You not going to be up. So she was like, no, I'm going to be up. Like, just hit me up and, you know, we go from there. I'm going to send you my address. So I'm like, okay, cool, bet or whatever. So in my mind, I'm like, okay, bitch. I know something gonna go down tonight. I just know something gonna go down tonight. So, you know, I had already had a fresh shower and shit like that. And I was like, shit, let me go ahead and pop my little pussy pill. I call it a pussy pill, y'all. I might do a video. I was supposed to do a video about it a long time ago. But I was like, let me pop my pussy pill to make sure everything is good. Everything is fresh down there. Because you want to make sure your hygiene is good and everything is fresh. I just wanted to make sure I was extra fresh. And most of the time when I pop my pussy pill, it's really like after I get off my period. Because, you know, when you're on your period, kind of like, you just want to feel fresh again after you get off your cycle. So that's normally when I use it. So I just popped the pussy pill because I was like, I'm going to be working all night. I'm probably going to be walking around getting sweaty and shit like that. So I just want to make sure I stay fresh all night long. So, you know, I pop my little pussy pill.
Period!
But anyway, okay, so fast forward, I'm at work. And we were talking like on and off while I was at work. And then I got off of work and I hit her up like, hey, I'm about to pull up on you. So, you know, I'm about to pull up. So I pulled up on her. Now, when I got there, everything was cool, you know, and things like that. We didn't like pop it off like with getting to the get down, because we already knew something was gonna go down, right? So we in the bed. I took off my clothes. I got comfortable, and we in the bed and we watching a movie. Mind you, I get off of work at 4 a.m. and we started watching a movie. I probably didn't get to her crib till like almost like five in the morning, or almost five in the morning. So I'm there and we watching the movie. Now, mind you, I have not been with a girl by myself in a very long, long time. It's been a hot ass minute. So I ain't gonna lie, I was a little bit nervous. I was a little bit nervous about it because I haven't been with a girl by myself in a hot little minute. So I didn't know how it was gonna go. I just didn't know how it was gonna go down, you know? So we watching this movie and I can tell, you know, you can always feel that energy. Like, I'm pretty sure she was like, damn, okay, like, who gonna start popping it off? Is it gonna be me? Is it gonna be her? Like, how are we gonna do this shit? She was here to tell the story time with me. I actually wanted to do this story time with her, but I'm not in Dallas, so here I am by myself. Maybe one day I'll put her in a video. Anyways, so we in the bed, the movie go off, and we kind of like shooting the shit, you know, talking or whatever. And in my mind, I could tell like we both kind of like beating around the bush. So finally, she kind of said, so what we gonna do? Like, what's up? And I'm just like, what's up? Because like I said, it's been so long since I've been with a girl, so I just really didn't. I was trying to feel her energy and her vibe, like how she was gonna be, because I didn't know if she was gonna, you know, try something first, or she wanted me to like go for it first. Like, I didn't know, you know what I'm saying? So I was trying to feel it out. So it was real awkward and we kind of laughed about it. Y'all know I'm goofy and I'm sure she goofy too. So we just kind of laughed about it. So then I went in to go give her a kiss. Why is this bitch trying to play me? Talking about my damn lips. I went in to give her a kiss and her mouth was closed like this. Like, it didn't even feel like I was kissing her lips. And when I went to kiss her, I kind of laughed like, what are you doing? And she was like,
damn, your small ass lips.
Really trying to play me. Really trying to play me, like, damn, like, this is, I'm already kind of nervous. This is already awkward as fuck because it's been so long since I've been with a girl. And you over here trying to clown me, talking about my lips, bitch. So we kind of laughed about it or whatever. And then we got the kissing or whatever. And it was just like, it was kind of weird. It was a little bit off because I felt like I was a little bit nervous, like I said, because it'd been a little mini. And I feel like she was a little off because she probably felt the same way. You know what I'm saying? So then I got to kissing on her, kiss down on her, you know, her breast. Then, you know, I just went ahead and went down low. So I ate her out for a little bit. I don't think I even ate her out that long. I ate her out for a little bit. And like I said, it was just, it was a little off. I just really couldn't tell how she was feeling. Even through that, I couldn't really tell how she was feeling. And like way back when I was with a girl and I was doing stuff like that, I could really already tell their vibe and if they were into it and if they were feeling it, like right off the bat. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was good. But with her, I couldn't really tell. It was just like, bitch, what? No. So that happened and then she started, no, she didn't eat me out at this time, but like I had did that and then we got to the scissoring part, y'all. Oh my God. Y'all, we got to trying to do scissoring, okay? Now when we first did it, like we over here trying to figure out how, we over here trying to play connect the motherfucking dots, okay? The shit was not working. So like I said, it's been a long time since I've been with a fucking girl. Y'all, I'm sorry I'm clapping my hands. Y'all know I talk with my hands. I'm trying not to clap my hands. I hope I ain't been clapping my hands. Y'all, I'm so sorry. So we over here trying to scissor and shit. The shit is not working. And so it was one point in time where we were scissoring and she kind of moaned a little bit. So I'm like, okay, maybe we connected our clitoris together a little bit. So maybe there's a little sensation. And I was trying really, really hard, but it was hard. For one, let me tell you why it was hard. And it's never been that hard for me. It's never been that hard. From what I can remember with being with other girls and doing that, it was good. Like, it flowed. Like, it was right. We was connected in the right way. You know what I'm saying? But with us, we just could not get it right. We could not figure it out. So, for one, she thick as hell. She got a big ass and big thighs. Y'all know I got a big ass and big thighs. So, we two thick ass bitches over here trying to scissor, okay? Like, it looked like we doing fucking yoga moves. Like, bitch, it was difficult. It was difficult, okay? Like, we could not get it right to save our life. And in the middle of us trying to scissor and we switch, trying to switch positions to see what's gonna work for us and what's not gonna work for us. But, bitch, nothing was working for us. Nothing laughing was working. I kid you not. We was laughing. Like I said, I'm goofy, so we laughing. I'm like, bitch, what the fuck? And I'm in the middle of this. I'm like, bitch, we too thick. We too thick, bitches. This ain't gonna work. This ain't gonna work. It's not working. Like, I don't know. I don't know what else to do. Like, it's not working. And we tried. Like, we really tried, but we just kind of gave up. We kind of just gave up on that part. So then she started. She was like, what she said? No, she started eating me out. Man, it was cool, you know. It was whatever. Like, I feel like at the time, like, I don't think she was really into it. And I don't think I was into it like I should have been into it, you know. And I have a feeling it was kind of like, you gotta get to know each other's bodies. We don't know each other's bodies. I don't know what she like and how she like it. She don't know what I like and how I like it. You know, I can only go based off of what I've done to other people and like it's worked before. And you know, everybody's different, you know what I'm saying? And then plus it was our first time together, so it was a little awkward. It was a little off. But I feel like if we would have kept doing it, like we would have mastered it. But anyway, she started eating me out and it was cool. At first I wasn't moaning. Then I kind of just started to moan a little bit to kind of make it feel like I was into it. I feel like maybe if I moan, it'll make it seem like I'm just really, 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 really it'll make me get into it. I tried to trick my mind to make me get into it because it was just off. Like, it was so awkward. Like, it was, she probably will tell you it was awkward. It was awkward. So then she was like, it was cool or whatever. It wasn't terrible. It was cool. But then she was like, I
got a deal though.
Mind you, I've never used a dildo. I have never used a dildo a day in my life. I've never used one. I just never had a desire to go buy a dildo, go get a dildo. I've never used a dildo. But she said she had a dildo and a vibrator, so she went to go get that. And I went to go start to use it on her, and she was like,
I don't want that in me.
And I'm just like, why did you go get it? Oh, you want to use it on me? Oh, okay. But she was like, she didn't want nothing to do with the dildo. She was like, yeah, I cleaned it. It's clean and everything. She's like, but I just don't want it in me. Now, I don't know why she didn't want it in her. I never asked her that. Bitch, why you didn't want that dildo in you? I'm going to ask you now, if you're watching this video, why you didn't want that dildo in you? She didn't want it in her. So she started playing with me with the dildo. So she sticks the dildo in me and she starts, you know, fucking me with the dildo, you know. So, and it was very interesting. It's nothing like the real deal, of course, but I just try to make myself get into it. And I think she said she kept asking me like, she was doing it for a little hot minute. And you know, I was trying to get myself into it, so I started to moan and shit like that to try to trick my mind to just really get into it or whatever. And it was whatever. It wasn't terrible, you know, but it wasn't the best thing in the world either. But it wasn't terrible, you know what I'm saying? So she doing that, and she asked me, she was like, have you came yet? And I was like, I don't think so. Like, because in my mind, I didn't think I came. I was like, damn, do it look like I came? She was like, I think you came. And she pulled out the dildo, and it had little, I guess, stuff on it. TMI, I guess. So I'm like, oh, I guess I did. I don't know. So I asked her, did she come? She was like, yeah, I already came. So she said she already came. So I'm like, okay, maybe she enjoyed it a little bit since she already done came or whatever. But yeah, y'all, that whole situation with me being with a girl for the first time in a long time was just, it was awkward, and you could tell we both was kind of like nervous about it. So it was just awkward. Like, and I never had that happen with me being with a girl. Like, even when we doing threesomes and stuff, like with the cougar, and we did the scissor and shit like that, it went smooth, it was good. But this time around, I guess it's because it's been a long time. But yeah, y'all, it was real, real fucking awkward. And I promise you, if she was sitting right here telling this story time with me, she would tell you it was awkward. Awkward? Bitch, I can't talk. See, that's how awkward it was. Bitch can't even talk. But she would tell you it was real fucking awkward, y'all. So, you know, we tried. That was our first time linking up and our first time doing something sexual together. Like I said, it wasn't terrible, but it wasn't the best thing in the world, you know. I was expecting a little bit more, and I'm pretty sure she was expecting a little bit more. So, and like I said before, I was just like, I feel like it was that way because we didn't really know each other's bodies like that, and we were just nervous. And it's been a long time for me since I've been with a girl by myself, and yeah. So yeah, that's my awkward ass story time. You know, the fail. It was definitely an epic fail. But I feel like if we probably would have still kept messing around and really just got a feel of each other, I feel like it would have got better. But you know, we didn't really do that. We couldn't really do that. You know, I'm here, so I really couldn't stay in touch like that. Anyway, as y'all can see, I'm back in San Antonio. But yeah, y'all, that is my awkward ass story time with Judy, okay? Awkward as hell, okay? I'm probably gonna do a, I wanna do a video with her anyway when I get back home or whenever I'm back home for good. And I'll probably like ask her some questions. I'll probably do a Q&A so y'all can ask questions and shit like that and she can answer it and y'all can kind of get her side, her perspective of everything. Cause I don't know, maybe she did enjoy it. Maybe she got something out of it in some point, I don't know. But yeah, y'all, that is my awkward ass story time, my cringy ass story time with being with a girl for the first time in a long, 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 long ass time. So yeah, comment below what y'all think about it. Have y'all ever had a cringy moment, sexual moment with somebody and it's been a little minute and things just didn't go as planned or how you expected it to go? Comment below and let me know. Like up this video if you want more story times like this or similar to it, or just more story times in general, and we can go from there. And make sure you subscribe and make sure you hit that bell so you're always notified whenever I upload another lit ass video, because you already know we always stay lit over here, okay? So yeah, and roll to 1k, baby. We almost there. I think we like 149 or 147 away from hitting 1k. I'm so excited. Y'all already know I'm doing a 1k giveaway. I'm doing a 1k giveaway and it's gonna be a big ass 1k giveaway. So y'all keep liking on my videos, keep commenting, keep sharing, keep subscribing to your girl, you know, tell everybody about me, okay? Because we lit over here, baby. And yeah, y'all, I'm finna go. I am out. That is my story time. And like I always say, tell your mommy, your daddy, your auntie, your uncle, your cousins, and them to subscribe to your girl. Because we what? We lit. And we stay lit, baby. And until the next video, your girl is out.